Yes, ma'am. This afternoon. Hello, Prof. Hello, Prof. Hello, Prof.
Hello, Prof.
Yeah, okay.
Good evening, sir.
Yeah, good evening.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you clearly.
Okay, but my video is not showing yet. Okay. Oh, can you see me?
We cannot see your screen.
I'm
to share it. Are you able to share your screen by clicking on that green button?
I'm not showing it yet.
Okay, you know what? Let me give you host. Be sure. first. Good. Just a moment. Let me co-host. Okay. Please, can you try now and share now?
I'm coming, bro. It's not that I can't share the documents. My screen is not showing at all. I can't see myself.
Okay, you should be able to see yourself. Your video is in.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you clearly.
But I can't see myself yet.
Yes, just try and share your screen. If your screen can come up, I think that's good to go.
Okay. Hello, good evening, everybody. Hello, Prof, my host.
Yes, we can hear you.
Okay, you can hear me. Okay, good evening, everybody. My video is yet to come up, but I'd like us to commence the class. So sorry for the delay. Sorry for the delay with network issues. I hope you all had a great day. You're welcome to today's class, and my name is Adesua Osaidekere. I'll be taking you taxation today, along with my other lecturer, Mr. Chima. He took taxation classes on Tuesday. I guess you all followed. Okay. For today, hello, Prof.
Yeah, we can see your screen. Okay.
You can see my screen. Okay, all right, thank you. So we are looking at taxation. You're welcome to SA Online Video Lectures. This is effective. So just quickly go through the class rules for today, okay? First, students are expected to be muted on both audio and video. And the essence of this is to ensure that there's proper coordination of the video lectures, okay? Students are allowed to use the chat button to ask questions. So within the during the classes, you can just post your questions, and after the class, we'll entertain every, I'll go through the questions that have been asked and try to give an answer to all. But in case you are facing any technical difficulties from your end, you can call our helpline, the number that is showing above, or you can send a chat to the online WhatsApp FCA Zoom class that you've been added to already. Then students are expected to be cordial and professional when using the chat button to ask questions or express their concerns. Students are advised to listen attentively during lectures rather than writing, since lecture materials would have been provided ahead of each class, although key points that might aid understanding might be jotted down. All questions will be attended to after the lectures. I've said that before. Then feel free to call or chat me up. Like I said earlier, my name is Adesua. So you can go to the FCA Zoom platform on WhatsApp, search for Adesua and save my number from there. You are free to call me anytime to ask questions or clarifications and also to submit your assignments if any is given during the class. Okay. So first and foremost, we'll be taking three topics today, if time permits us. We'll start with withholding tax, then followed by luxury tax, and then tertiary education tax, which is tax. So beginning from withholding tax, I guess we are together. Kindly pay attention, okay? Don't say withholding tax. What are we expected to know about withholding tax regarding our taxation exam and also in our normal day taxation practice? When we say withholding tax, as a professional, as a student of ICANN, you're expected to know what withholding tax is all about, what it means, first and foremost. Secondly, the rate that is expected to, that you charge on withholding tax. Then what are the penalties? If you don't pay the exact amounts to be deducted, what are the penalties? Or what are the advantages of withholding tax, disadvantages, and so on and so forth? So that's what we'll be looking at in this class. But before I go into withholding tax in details, I want to carry us along with what is required of us for our taxation exam, which will hopefully come up in July 2020. The taxation exam currently for this new syllabus usually entails two sections, your section A and section B. Section A is a section for multi-choice questions, okay? Usually 20 questions, which carries 1 mark each, and in total will give you 20 marks. So you're expected to attempt the multi-choice questions. The options are already given to you. You just pick the answers that go along with the question. And for Section B have a total of 6 questions, which is theory questions, okay? 6 questions in total. And marks for each question is 20 marks, but you are only expected to attempt 4 out of those 6 questions. So attempting 4 of those questions will give you 18, in addition to the previous 20 marks in your multi-choice question, bring you to a total of about 100 marks. Therefore, it's important for us to not only prepare our minds to learn the calculations, the company income tax, and all other calculations that are involved. We should also, I can also test your understanding on the theory part, and it will help you too in practice in your various offices when you're completing different forms of taxation as required by law. Okay. So we'll be starting with withholding tax. What is withholding tax? What does withholding tax mean? Withholding tax is a tax, is an advance payment of tax. Okay, when we say an advance payment of tax, it means this form of tax is deducted once, and you are paying that tax in advance. The essence of calling it an advance tax means you can use it to offset your subsequent tax or liability at the end of that year, okay? Withholding tax is a tax deducted at source from payments made to a taxable person for the supply of goods and services. The withholding tax is deducted at source and is used to offset against any subsequent tax liability that may be due in respect of what other income. Let's say, for instance, I am Adesua. I own a company, Adesua Limited, okay? That company is involved with supply of, let's say I supply cement, okay? I supply cement, that's all I do in the company, supply cement. So I, as a company, Adesua Limited, I'm a taxable person. And what the law says is that if I supply, let's say, for instance, we have another company, Aminat Limited, okay? I supply them cement every 2 months. I have a contract with Aminat Limited, who is a company. That Aminat Limited, that is the company, is going to the tax authority. That Aminat Limited that receives goods and services from I as a supplier, that Aminat Limited is a tax agent. What it means is that for one, anytime I supply cement to Aminat Limited, Aminat Limited is expected to what? Pay me a certain amount, right? Are we together? Pay me a certain amount. That amount shows the what? The payment for the goods that I've supplied to what? Aminat Limited. But before Aminat Limited pays me the amount, what she's expected to do is that based on the contract, before paying me the total sum of cement that I've supplied to her, what she will do is that Aminat will deduct withholding tax from the lump sum. Let's say the estimate of cement supplied was worth 100,000 naira. What Aminat will do as a company is that she will deduct what 10% withholding tax. It means she's deducting that amount on behalf of the tax authority. So therefore, Aminat Limited is a tax agent. Okay, she's a tax agent. She's one representing what the tax authority. So before she pays me my 100,000 naira, she'll do a schedule. The amount due to me is what 100,000 naira. She'll calculate 10% of 100,000 naira. That is what? 10% of 100,000 is how much? 10,000 naira, right? So she'll deduct 10% of 100,000 naira. Okay, can you hear me now? So sorry for the break. So as I was saying, what she will do is that she'll deduct what 10,000 naira from the 100,000 naira. The amount that will be paid to me is what 90,000 naira. So I already know that before my money is paid to me, a tax of what 10% will be deducted for what withholding tax. Then Aminat Limited, who is the what agent, who is the one what she will be the one to now remit the 10,000 naira to the relevant tax authority. If it's a company, she remit to what FIRS. So at the end of 2018, that same year, by the time I do my tax computation, whatever company comes is due by this one limited, I can now tell the relevant to tell FIRS that, oh, 10,000 naira have been deducted during the year in form of what withholding tax. In form of withholding tax by limited, I will present the receipts, which shows that I have a what credit note. That amount we used was to offset, to reduce the company income tax. that will be paid by me at the end of what 2018. So that's all we mean. The peculiarities of what withholding tax. How is it? What makes it different? Withholding tax is not what is not optional. Adesso Unlimited cannot decide that, oh, please, I'm in Unlimited. When you intend paying me the amount due to me, I will not want to be charged withholding tax. I don't have a what option because it's statutory. I'm expected to what? To I'm Unlimited is expected to deduct the amount before what? Paying me the next sum. Okay? Then secondly, withholding tax is what? It's an advance payment of income tax and is usually utilized as what? Tax or credits at the end of the year. In most cases, it represents the final tax in most what? Cases. And let's go further. Look at the transactions, the rates, the tax authority, and what tax remittance. We need to know what nature of transactions can you deduct withholding tax on? Okay? What nature of transactions according to what? To the law. One, for transactions or payments to deduct withholding tax on. One, we have what? Royalties. You can deduct withholding tax on royalties, on rent, on dividends, on interest, on commission, on consultancy fees, technical fees, management fees, okay? Director's fees, building construction, contract what supplies. Are we together? For the tax, for payment of withholding tax is usually in two forms. Either a company is paying the withholding tax or an individual is paying the withholding tax. We know companies are what? Companies would have registered under what? Federal Inland Revenue Service, which is FRS, okay? Or individuals, those ones generally register under what? The state internal revenue service. For instance, if Adesua, okay, as an individual in Lagos State, the state revenue service here is what LRS. It means I would have registered with what Lagos Internal Revenue Service. So when the withholding tax is deducted from me, it has to be paid to what the state internal revenue service that are what I'm resident in. So for companies, what are the rates based on these transactions that are what that are permitted by law? For royalties, the rate is what 10%. The same applies for rent, dividends, interest, commission. They are all what 10%. But for directors' fees, companies are not expected to pay anything for what withholding tax. Building construction 5%, contract supplies 5%. And the relevant tax authorities for companies was Federal Inland Revenue Service. But for individuals, the tax rate differs. Okay, for individuals, the tax rates for royalties, rent, dividends, interest, and interest is still 10%, while others are at a rate of what? 5%. Like I said earlier on, the relevant tax authority for individuals depends on what? The state internal revenue service, where the taxpayer is, where the recipient is what? Is resident in. So we can go further. However, there are some other form of individuals that are not listed on this table, as you can see. One, those that are resident in FCT, as Abuja, Federal Capital Territory, Abuja, and those that are non-resident individuals in Nigeria. It means they are Nigerians, they are not living in Nigerians, but they earn their income outside Nigeria, okay? This group of individuals, their withholding tax is payable to Federal Inland Revenue Service. Then also, members of what Nigerian Armed Forces, the police, officers of Nigerian Foreign Service, persons resident outside Nigeria, okay? But they derive their income in Nigeria. Their withholding tax is also payable to FIRS. But for withholding tax on dividends, interest, rents, and royalties suffered by the withholding tax on dividends, interest, rents, and royalties. Can you hear me?
Hello?
Okay. The withholding tax, the withholding tax on dividend, interest rates, and royalties, when served by non-resident, represent final what tax. It means if as an individual, okay, or even as a company, I pay out dividends to my shareholders, that amount, okay, that withholding tax, that amount paid as dividends, the withholding tax paid on it represents the word final tax, okay? Also, withholding tax on interest and dividends is the final tax award for individuals. For tax, what is the, for to remit withholding tax, what does it what entails? How many days are you expected to remit withholding tax? Taxes are to be withheld from payments due to what corporate bodies and individuals at the rates listed above. We've looked at the transactions and the rates that is expected for both companies and what individuals. However, within 30 days from the date the amount was deducted, the tax agent, the agent is expected to what, remit the withholding tax to the relevant tax authority within 30 days from the date the amount was what deducted. Okay. And for penalties, there are sanctions according to the law. If the sanctions are usually in two phases, one, if the company or the individual fails to deduct, what is the penalty? Or if the individual, having deducted the amount from the what, from the taxpayer, but refuses to pay to the board within 21 days from the date of the amount, what is the penalty on these words, on this above? If the tax agents fail to deduct the amount, okay, from the taxpayer, you are expected not to be ignorant of the law, right? You are guilty to an offense and you are liable to pay a penalty of what, 10% per annum of the tax withheld or not remitted, as the case may be. So what it means is that if, for instance, I'm expected to pay 50 naira to a contractor, someone that supplies me goods. Or let's even use this example I've been using so far. Adeswa Limited, I was paid 10,000 naira was withholding tax, and I was paid a net of what, 90,000, which means that 10,000 naira should be remitted towards the relevant tax authority. If Aminat Limited fails to remit the amount to the relevant tax authority, she's liable to pay a penalty of what, 10% per annum of the tax withheld or not remitted. So she will pay the 10,000 naira, which she was supposed to remit, and then she will pay 10% of 10,000 naira. 10% of 10,000 naira is how much? 1,000. So she actually has to pay a total of 11,000 naira, both penalty and the amount to be remitted to the what, relevant tax authority. Then if she also fails to deduct and pay to the board. Hello, Prof, can you hear me? My host, kindly confirm if you can hear me. Hello. Okay. I guess you can hear me now. Okay. Sorry for the next video.
Yeah, if we can hear you.
Thank you very much. So let's continue with this stuff. This is in phases, okay? So first,
Aminat Limi fails to the relevant tax authority, she is expected to pay the what 10,000 naira, which is the withholding tax, and also pay 10% of 10,000 naira, which is 1,000 to it, which will be the what the penalty. So it's of 11,000 naira will be paid to the relevant tax authority. However, if Aminat Limi fails to deduct the amount, or having deducted, she fails to remit towards FRS. Okay, it that one is an offense punishable on conviction, a fine of 5,000 naira, and then in addition to the tax deducted, okay, then they will also charge what interest at the prevailing commercial what rate. It depends on the interest rates available at that time. Then for withholding tax and double taxation, what we say by taxation, okay? What it means is probably when an income has been taxed more than once, double taxation. In this case, for withholding tax rate and double taxation, remember previously we highlighted that there are some cases of that are non-residents in Nigeria, but they derive their income outside the country. There are also individuals that are non-residents in Nigeria and they derive their income in Nigeria. We highlighted the relevant tax authority that they are paid withholding tax rate. Relief is to ensure that a certain income being what's received by an individual or a company is what not taxed more than once. Okay, what happens is that countries try to sign double taxation treaty in form of agreement binds both countries, okay, on a certain percentage to be charged on incomes received by non-residents and residents, what non-resident individuals that generate their income in both countries. Near the double taxation treaty between Nigeria and any other country, the resident of such country in receipt of income in Nigeria will be entitled to a double taxation relief as the rate contained in double taxation was treaties. So the double taxation rate would have been what agreed. Okay. The withholding tax rate is reduced to 7.5% for dividends, interest, royalty for recipients of a country which has double taxation agreements with what Nigeria. However, there are some countries that have double taxation agreement with Nigeria. Please, it's important for us to know this. This can also come out in the multi-choice questions. They can list five different countries and which country above, which country below, it's not among the countries that have signed double taxation treaty with Nigeria. So just try and know them. There are no many. Canada, Czech Republic, France, Netherlands, Pakistan, Romania, United Kingdom, South Africa, Philippines, and Belgium. Okay. The operation of withholding tax system. Withholding tax system, like I've explained before, the withholding tax process begins from when any of the payments, excluding dividends above, royalties, rents, directors' fees, etc., when any of those payments is being made by the payer, who is an agent of the relevant tax authority for collection and remittance of what withholding tax. The accurate tax rate is applied, and the amount is deducted from the payment, and the net amount is paid to the what supplier. However, dividends can only be paid by a corporate body. But for currency of deduction, the transaction that occurred between a company and its supplier could be in different currencies. I Adesua Limited can have a contract with a company in United States of America, for example, okay, and the currency used in such transaction may not necessarily be Naira. In that case, let's say the currency for of transaction is what, dollar. How do I pay? How will that reflect if the withholding tax is deducted? In what currency will that withholding tax be paid? Okay. For withholding tax, the currency of transaction is the currency in which the tax is to be deducted and paid to the relevant tax authority. So the currency of transaction is in that same currency that you pay the what withholding tax to the relevant tax authority. It is not your duty, please, to go and convert the currency to what the currency to Naira. Let's say we are using Nigeria to currency to Naira. I'm paying on behalf of the taxpayer to the relevant tax authority. No, you must pay in the what in the currency of transaction. Where the transaction is in foreign currency, okay, the tax is to be withheld in the foreign currency and paid to the relevant tax authority through Central Bank of Nigeria. So what happens is that when you pay the withholding tax, okay, in the bank as check, what CBN will do is that they will effect the necessary conversion rate, they apply it, and they will be the ones to credit the appropriate government with the what amount in Naira. And when withholding tax is being deducted by the tax agent, what is required by the tax agent? Okay, before you go to the bank to pay, what other documents are required by you in addition to the check that you'll be paying? Each withholding tax check that is being paid to the revenue service must be accompanied with a payment schedule. A payment schedule, this is a list of what of documents, okay, that contains the details that is required by the revenue service in order for them to ascertain. One, it's to ascertain the nature of contracts that exist between the tax agent and the taxpayer. They also want to know the income paid, the income that was agreed for the transaction. They want to know the withholding tax that was deducted, just to check the accuracy of all the informations and to ensure that the information complies with the relevant requirements for what withholding tax. The payment schedule must contain the following particulars. One, the name of the taxpayer who suffered the deduction. The example we've been using so far, the name of the taxpayer will be what? Adesua Limited, because I'm the one suffering the withholding tax. The address, I'm resident in Lagos, my office address to be stated there, okay? The nature of the activities, stroke services, superior cover. Like I said earlier, and I said I'm Adesua Limited is involved in what? In supply of what? Cement. Okay, so that would be the nature of service, the period covered in the year 2018. Oh, it could be January 2018. Just the period covered, it could be January to December 2018 as what as required. Then the tax identification number. In fact, this is now compulsory in line with the current finance bill. Okay, all companies are expected to have their tax identification numbers, even as individuals, please. Yeah, a worker in a company expected to have your what team. So the tax identification number will also be what is part of the what particulars required. The total amount payable is what? 100,000 naira. The rate of tax applied in this case is 10,000 naira with our example. Okay. The amount of tax withheld. How much of tax was withheld? 10,000 naira. The balance paid to the taxpayer, 90,000 naira. The tax contract for which returns were being what made was the contract you stated. The date of what payment, let's say 28 November 2018. The check number and the what date. All of these particulars, you will put that in addition with what you pay the check and then ensure that all these particulars are added to the what? To the teller after paying the check, and then you submit to the relevant tax authority. Let's say for companies, it's FRS. So you go to FRS, submit all the supporting documents along with the evidence of payment. Okay. Then let's go to the next. Withholding tax credit notes. When payment is made to the bank or to withholding tax section of the revenue service, okay? For withholding tax deducted at source, FRS will issue what we call credit notes in favor of the taxpayer whose names are contained in the withholding tax schedule. The credit notes are to be forwarded by the collection agents to the taxpayers who suffer the deduction to enable them claim tax credits against their tax loss liabilities for the relevant assessment years. For withholding tax credits, in these days, it's the withholding tax credits is usually in form of, it's usually in form of, it's sent via mail. So you get the notification. Once a tax agent pays the relevant tax authority, let's say they pay FRS withholding tax on your behalf, immediately the check is cleared and they've assessed the necessary documents that's been attached to the payment, and they confirm it's accurate. Immediately, the mail is being sent to the company. So Adesua Limited, I have a company mail. I receive a mail from FRS credits what notice. They will let me know the amount that was paid by the tax agent on my behalf. All the details will be stated there. The amount that was paid, the same way it's reflecting here. Okay, I don't know if we've seen a sample of credits notes. Okay, so I will get all the details. So the taxpayer will be aware that the tax agents have remitted such amount on behalf of the taxpayer, and the taxpayer can now use that, okay, subsequently, probably at the end of the year, to reduce the tax liability payable by the taxpayer for the relevant year of assessment. However, it's important for us to know that even if the tax agent gives you a letter and say, oh, please, when you're going to FRS to submit your company income tax, don't worry, I'll give you, especially when you're assisting. In Nigeria these days, a lot of companies just deduct the withholding tax. They don't remit on behalf of the taxpayers. So at the end of the year, you will start looking for your withholding tax credit notes to use to reduce your company income tax. In fact, this is actually the withholding tax credit note is actually a right to the taxpayer. Okay, it's important for you to get them after the tax agent has remitted, so it will reduce your tax liability, or else you also be charged twice, which is double taxation in that case. So even if the tax agent gives you a letter, that alone will not suffice. Payment certificate and treasure. Let's move on. A payment certificate is usually issued in favor of the tax agent. So for the tax agent has something to hold to. The tax agent is giving a payment certificate to show that he or she has made payment of tax on behalf of the taxpayer, and that the amount was deducted as source. The tax certificate, the payment certificate, is the only document evidence that the tax agents will have towards show until FRS issues the withholding tax receipts. Okay. Then for refunds and setoffs, there are cases where withholding tax has been paid in excess. What is expected to be done as the tax agent or as the taxpayer? When withholding tax is paid in excess, okay, it's important for the taxpayer tax agents to notify the what relevant tax authority within 90 days. They have to what, notify them within 90 days of what application. They will have to apply to FRS and notify them of the all the details, also provide the relevant documents needed, okay? After that, if the relevant tax authority now ascertain that, oh, there's actually, this amount was actually paid in excess, no, FRS will not refund the money to you, okay? There may just be an agreement between the tax consultant and the company that that withholding tax excess will be used probably in subsequent years towards reduce tax liability. Man, government, they will not refund your money to you. That's just the truth. So they cannot decide towards to move it to that. They will agree towards to use the excess towards to offset subsequent tax liability for the company. Then for ministries, parastatals, and other agencies of government, what are their roles? What role do they play, okay, in terms of withholding tax? These various ministries and agencies of government play a dual role in tax collection procedures. Some of these roles include, one, they act as what an agent. Like I said, individuals, companies, and all, they are all acting as what agents of what of the relevant tax authority, agents of what governments, okay? They are acting as agents to deduct withholding tax from contracts, which sums the contract sums, which is payable for their what contract. Then they also act as agents in collection of VAT what amounts towards contractors. No, most times for contracts, it's not only withholding tax that is deducted. Withholding tax is deducted, value added tax is also deducted. In accordance with the finance bill from February 2020, VAT it's now at 7.5%, okay, which differs from withholding tax, which is 5% for contracts, okay. So what's on that schedule, they just have to ensure that they calculate VAT separately, calculate withholding VAT separately, and then the next sum is what is paid to the what, is what is given to the what, to the taxpayer at the SUA Limited. Before Aminat Limited will pay me my money, she will deduct 7.5% for value added tax, and she will also deduct 5% for what, withholding tax. So I will get the net at the end of the day. For value added tax is paid directly to what? To FIRS, Federal Inland Revenue Service. Okay, so that's part of the duty. They just act as agents for collection and remittance to the what, to government. What are the rights and obligations of taxpayers? Rights and obligation of taxpayers. Okay. For taxpayers, what are their rights? For taxpayers, what are their rights and obligations? As a taxpayer, what are your rights? You should know your rights, okay? As a taxpayer, if you suffered any tax that is being deducted as source, which is withholding tax, you are expected, you are entitled to a demand from the what taxpayer. Evidence that the payer has not only deducted the what tax, but they have also been the amount has been accounted to the what relevant tax authority. It is your right. It's just that most cases, I know probably when it comes to contracts, okay, especially in Nigeria, some companies may have, before getting that contract, maybe some persons may have intervened and assisted them getting the contract. So at the end of the day, whenever they are paid their net amounts and the company fails to remit the relevant remit, either withholding tax or value added tax on their behalf, so they can use to offset their company income tax at the end of the year. In most cases, some of them may not want to request for it. They may just feel that, oh, the amount is not much, we'll just pay our company income tax. And in Nigeria, we even know many companies, in fact, we keep some an organization I work with, we kept writing letters and letters and letters. But nowadays, it's even very easy. Any company, any tax agent that pays on your behalf, you will get the receipts straight in your mail. You get it and you just print the words, the withholding tax credits. You print it out so that at the end of the year, when you are about to pay your company income tax, you just present it. Give your tax consultant who will present it along with your words, your audited financial statements that will be what submitted, okay? So it's important. The evidence should be what? The original receipt issued by a relevant tax authority. Now you get the receipt via mail for FRS, okay? Otherwise, he or she is unlikely giving what credit for the tax already paid against his total tax liability for a given year of what assessment. Then for as a taxpayer, you are also expected to what? To declare all your sources of income. All your sources of income, which includes the income that are tax exempted. All your sources of income has to be what included and stated. So the relevant tax authority will know how your what they can easily assess how They can easily assess the income that you received during the year. They can assess those that suffered withholding tax during the year, and so on and so forth and so forth. Withholding tax, what are the advantages and the disadvantages? For withholding tax, one, you already know, oh, it's a source of revenue towards the government, okay? The first source of revenue, taxation is a source of revenue to government. Then it also helps to what, reduce incidence of tax or evasion. There are cases where so many companies, there are some cases where some companies will not register with the relevant tax authority, but they'll be in operation, okay? Let's say, for instance, LYZ, they've been operating for a period of 1 year and they have refused to register. And they supply goods to another company who acts as a tax agent, and that one deducts the withholding tax and value-added tax on behalf of the taxpayer, goes to FRS to remit. On remitting to FRS, FRS will now discover that, oh, this company has not even what registered with what FIRS. So it's also a way to what reduce incidence of what tax evasion. Okay. So what they will now do, they can get the name of the company, get the address, all those information. Don't forget, they're already on the payment schedule. Okay. So the tax authority can now go ahead to what to look for the taxpayer and find out why they have not registered and all other things involved. They will be liable to penalties and so on and so forth, okay? So thirdly, it also helps in expanding the tax net by robbing people that are previously unknown to the tax authorities, like I've said already, okay? It helps in determining a person's turnover and thus ascertaining the correct income for tax purposes. If Adesua Limited is a company that deals with only contracts, it means all my income will be from the contracts that I'm involved in with all the companies. So it means every company I deal with, we always have a schedule of the income that they have paid to me within a particular period of time. And that amount would have been, by the time they submit those informations to the relevant tax authority, they will have an idea of the total income that I've received from all the companies I've done contracts with within a period of time. Okay, so they will have an idea of the turnover of Adesua Limited and be able to ascertain the how accurate my what my tax computation and all other informations are provided in my audited financial statements. Okay, also they will help, that will also help to ascertain the accuracy of all information I've submitted for tax purpose. And also, it makes tax payments less cumbersome to the taxpayer. Like, you don't necessarily, Adesua Limited is on contract only. I don't necessarily have to go to tax office to go and pay withholding tax or value added tax. The tax agents have already done that on my behalf. They deduct the amount at source. They deduct for withholding tax, they deduct the amount, okay? Go to pay to the relevant tax authority. So it has made the process less stressful for me. I don't need to bother myself to go to a tax office again to pay tax. Then it also involves little or no cost of collection. It is self-accounting in nature. In fact, computation of tax these days are usually self-assessments, okay? Oh, in the various offices, they already have a template of the income and everything. You assess yourself. For company contracts, you assess yourself based on the information available in your company and then you submit it to the relevant tax authority. Those ones will now go ahead to check the accuracy if it actually declares the correct income like you have stated in your accounts and so on and so forth. Then it saves time for revenue officers to attend to other duties. Since the tax agents are already carrying all of that out on their behalf, they will have time to do other things. All they need to do is to confirm the accuracy of the information submitted by the tax agent on behalf of the taxpayer. I believe we are following. Okay. So next is what disadvantages of withholding tax. We've looked at the advantages. We'll also look at the disadvantages. What are the disadvantages? A high rate of withholding tax is likely to affect your operational performance of what most businesses. The application of withholding tax affects the cash flow of most businesses as they receive amounts less than what they have estimated or budgeted for per the invoices they have issued. What we mean here is from Adesua Limited, who is a company that's involved in contracts, okay? Any amount received by me is usually the net, which means tax would have been deducted. Then they will pay me the net amount. That can also affect the operational performance of my business because I may not have, if all the companies I deal with are all based on contracts, they all pay me the net amount. If I had received the gross amount, for instance, from all these companies, I may have sufficient amounts to carry out operational activities in the organization. But since the tax has been deducted, I'm only left to the net. That may affect my cash flow. The company may not be liquid enough, okay, compared to when I have my 100% of payment expected by these companies. Then it is likely to discourage hard work by revenue officers since it is self-accounting in nature. In fact, these revenue officers don't need to stress themselves as much as before, okay? So it may discourage hard work, which means increased laziness on the part of revenue officers. Then there's an exercise for us to look at, okay? For withholding tax can be asked in two forms, both in written, it can be asked in your multi-choice questions and also in your theory part, okay? So it's important for us to know these details. What withholding tax entails, the rates, the transactions or payments that withholding tax to be deducted from, the advantages, the disadvantages, the companies that have double taxation treaties in Nigeria, okay? And so on and so forth. So let's look at the exercise one. This SAA Insurance PLC engaged the services of Desu Consulting Limited for corporate structure and strategic management in line with the ongoing recapitalization exercise within the insurance industry in Nigeria. The fee for the assignment is worth 65 million. So 65 million is what is the amount payable, okay? As the leading company in the new mega insurance company, Asahi Insurance paid the agreed fee on 30th June 2013, upon which no withholding tax was deducted. What is the tax implication of this word action? Let's look at the solution together. This is Asahi Insurance PLC. They engage in services towards Desu Consulting Limited. Okay, these services require the payment of about 65 million naira. At the end of the period, the insurance company made the payment to Desu Consulting Limited without deducting. Hello, host. Can you confirm if you can hear me?
Hello,
hello.
I can hear you.
Okay, all right, thank you. Asahi Insurance PLC, okay. After the engagement had come to an end, the insurance company paid what Desu Consulting Limited without deducting withholding tax, which was expected to be deducted as before paying the next toward Desu Consulting Limited. So now they are asking us, we are required to show what the tax implication for this was action. The tax implication for Asahi Insurance Limited as the tax agent is expected to remit the money to the withholding tax authority, to the relevant tax authority, but did not failed to. In accordance with Section 82 of Capital Income, Company Income Tax Act, is expected to, one, the insurance company is liable to a penalty of 10% of the tax, not withheld or not was remitted. No, we've said that earlier on. Then in addition, also pay what the tax itself. So the withholding tax is what? If we have to calculate the withholding tax of 65 million, which is what 10% of 65 million, withholding tax is 6,500,000. But the penalty for the insurance company for not deducting and what remitting, penalty to deduct is what also 10%. 10% of what? 10% of the withholding tax that was supposed to be what remitted. So which is 10% of 6,500,000. The total is what 650,000 naira. So the total payment for Asahi Insurance to pay to the relevant tax authority is what 7,150,000 naira. Okay. Just note the calculation done, okay? If you still don't understand, you can call me after the class. I will explain better to you. Okay. Then let's look at the second exercise. I advise you get our calculator close to us to make it easier for us to understand, okay? So this is the second exercise, second example we're looking at, okay? This is Adebola Nigeria Limited. Adebola Nigeria Limited has been trading for many years. The company make up its accounts to 31st December annually, which means the accounting period is from 1st of January to 31st December every year. The extract from its statement of comprehensive income for the years ended 31st December 2018 and 2019 as adjusted for tax purposes as follows. We have the year ended 2019-2018. We have our trading profits. We have our trading profits, bank interest received, debenture interest received, dividends received from Adese Mowo Limited, Okay. Dividend paid to shareholders, the amount of both years as stated there. Required. A. Compute the company's tax liabilities for the relevant years of assessment. Ignore capital allowances. B. Determine the net withholding tax payable or receivable by Adebola Nigeria Limited arising from dividends paid and received by what? By it. So let's look at the first requirement together. First one says we should compute the company's tax liabilities for the relevant tax day. In computing the tax liabilities, is there your calculator close by? Okay. Okay, this is Adebola Nigeria Limited. Requirement A. So what it means is that for examination purpose, okay, please, the presentation of your solution is very, very important, okay? First and foremost, the company highlighted to you in the requirement should be there, okay? Here you can see I have Adebola Nigeria Limited stated here as the heading, okay? Then it was the requirement one, company's tax liability for the relevant years of assessment. So we'll look at the calculations for both years together. This 2019 and for 2018. So get the tax liabilities for each year. They said no capital allowance is required. From the question given above, you'll notice that the company generated income had different sources of income. Let's look at it again. The company had different sources of income. From their normal trading, they had an income of 14 million for 2019. Then they also received what? Interest, bank interest. They received debenture interest. Okay, so these are their what? Sources of income. Don't forget, they say all the sources of income was what? Declared and stated to the what? Relevant tax authority. Remember, we had said that in our previous discussion. So for 2019, the trading profit here is what? This 14 million. Sorry. This is not very clear, but this is one. So this is 14 million for 2019. Bank interest received. Note here, gross, which means the amount that was received was the what? Was 100% of the amount. Net, a particular percentage has been what? Deducted. Gross, 100% of the amount. So the interest received from the what? Bank was what? 2,400,000. Then for the venture interest, the amount was also received in gross. 100% was received, and the amount is what? 800,000. So we'll sum the three figures above, okay? It will give us our total profits or what? Assessable profits. Total profits, also known as assessable profits. So our assessable profits for 2019 is what? 17,200,000 naira. Okay? Then, from our assessable profits, we can then calculate our company income tax and our education tax, which is tertiary education tax. For company income tax is at a rate of what, 30%, okay? So 30% on 17,200,000, you have 5,160,000 naira. 30% on 17,200,000, you get 5,160,000 naira. But for education tax is 2% of accessible profit, which is 2% on 17,200,000, which is 344,000 naira. The same goes for 2018. From our table above, you can see the sum. Okay, let's go there. For 2018, we can also see from the income received by the company Adebola Nigeria Limited, trading profit, bank interest, debenture interest received. So those are the amounts brought forward in our calculations. So the summation of this will give you 12,400,000. The same we apply. Okay, our company income tax is what, 3,720,000. Our education tax is what, 248,000 naira. So please, probably after the class, you can use your calculator to press and confirm the values. Ensure you what you understand how we arrived at each of these words figures. Okay. Then let's move on. In the second requirement, we are asked to calculate the net withholding tax payable or receivable by Adebola Nigeria Limited. Don't forget, they had stated that Adebola also received other amounts and paid other awards, amounts, okay? And those amounts, withholding tax awards, are deducted from such amounts. So we'll look at 2019 and 2018, respectively. First, Adebola received dividends. The company received dividends, and the dividends they received for 2019 was 720,000 naira. If Adebola Limited received a dividend of 720,000 naira, it means what Adebola and they told us it was what it was net. So it means we need to find out what is the gross amount, what is 100% of that amount that the company paid Adebola Limited. Do you understand? Okay, so that would be 720,000. Sorry. Okay, this is it here. 720,000. 720,000, the same amount on both years. So we'll gross the amount, 100% of that amount. Since it's a company, withholding tax on the company is what, 10%, right? So we'll gross 10%. To gross the amount, it will be 720,000 times 100 over 90. To get this 90, 100 minus what, 10, will give us what, 90. So this 720,000 times 100 over 90 will give us what, 800,000. The same applies to 2018. So it means the gross amount on both years, the exact dividend, 100% of the dividend was what, 800,000. However, 10% was already what, deducted, and 10% of it is what, 80,000 naira. So it means the company deducted 80,000 naira before paying us a sum of what, 720,000 naira. Okay, and don't forget, this amount is already the final tax on this income that is received by Adebola Nigeria Limited. So we'll go further. The company Adebola Nigeria Limited also paid out what, dividends to their shareholders. We don't need tax on dividend paid. For 2019 and 2018, we have different amount. For 2019, they paid out a sum of 6 million naira. We don't need tax on it. It's 10% of 6 million, is 600,000 naira. But for 2018, they also paid out 4 million naira, and they charge 10%, which is the withholding tax rate of 4 million naira. So he had a total of 400,000. The net withholding tax payable, to get our withholding tax, the net withholding tax payable, which means we want to get the withholding tax payable, okay, by us. The withholding tax that we have paid. Hello, the withholding tax payable. So to calculate our withholding tax payable, is the withholding tax on dividends paid. We'll remove it from the withholding tax that was what received. Okay. So the dividends we paid, the company paid this amount of dividend. This was the withholding tax on it. That was all we brought down here. For 2018, so same applies. The dividends paid us 4 million. The withholding tax was worth 400,000. That's what we brought down here. Then the withholding tax that we had received, okay, for 2019 was 80,000. For 2018 is 80,000. So 600 minus 80,000 gave us 520,000 naira. 400 minus 80,000 will give us 320,000. So this amount is the withholding tax payable by Adebola Nigeria Limited. Okay. Please, after the class, ensure you go through it today. Or if it's already too late, you can go through it first thing tomorrow morning. Yes. So you understand all that we've talked about so far. But if you still don't understand, you can call me or chat me privately. I'll explain to you again. So that's all we have for withholding tax. We'll proceed to the next topic we have for today, which is LOLAC. If you have any questions, don't forget to send your questions in immediately after the class. I'll take the questions before we call it a day. So for luxury tax, what was the luxury tax? What do we understand by luxury tax and what comes to our mind, okay? Luxury tax, when we say luxury, first and foremost, we are referring to items that are non-essential items. Non-essential items, items that are not essential, okay, to individuals, essential to individuals. These items are usually expensive. They call them luxury items. So there's what we call luxury tax, okay? Which means a tax that is what imposed on luxury items. Luxury tax is tax imposed on goods and services that are considered by government to be what luxury goods and services. When we say luxury goods and services, what do we refer to? These goods and services are not considered to be what essential by government. They are usually expensive and they are consumed by wealthy class of the world society. Okay. Aside that, it's not needed in it's not essential, it's not our basic, it's not what we need every day to survive. For instance, as an individual, you need food to survive. Mm-hmm. And so many other basic and essential items are required and needed. However, luxury tax is targeted at rich people. Okay, they are more rich individuals or companies, rich people in general. They are the ones likely to purchase these what luxury items because they are usually what expensive. So, for goods and services that are classified as luxury, they are usually assessed to tax as a percentage of what sales price. So the percentage is usually charged on the sales price, the amount that was used to what purchase the luxury item. Okay. Luxury tax are usually levied in some countries. Currently, all around the world, there are some countries already involved in luxury tax. It means they charge, they tax their citizens on luxury items. Okay. We have Australia, India, Indonesia, Switzerland, Ireland, Chile, Turkey, Egypt, Tunisia, Botswana, South Korea, China. Okay, so Nigerian government has realized that it's important for them to also begin this form of taxation on luxury items. To increase the revenue of what government. No one for different types of taxation. Okay, the people usually say the poor, the rich don't pay as much as the poor do. So in this case, if the rich are buying luxury items, they are also expected to pay more what tax to the world government, which also serves as a source of revenue. So what items can we classify as what relevant goods, luxury goods and services? First and foremost, it started in August 2019, okay, during Goodluck Jonathan's regime, okay, they announced plans to introduce this form of tax and they listed some items that will be classified as what luxury tax that they will deducts tax on. Okay, so the following items are listed: private jets. We all know private jet is quite expensive, and the non-essential item by individuals, okay? Luxury jet, private jets, luxury yachts, luxury cars, business class through first class tickets of airlines, champagnes, wines, and spirits, the residential mansion in what? FCC. So that was what, during Goodluck Jonathan's region, those items that are classified as what? Luxury items. However, the implementation of this tax was suspended because of controversial issues that started generating. Okay, we all know the class of individuals that will suffer it, and they're not ready. There's controversies against it anyway. But in 2016, our then Minister of Finance, Mrs. Kemi Adeosun, reactivated this same tax, luxury tax, and they, but then during in 2016 when it was reactivated by her, their federal goods and services and their rates were not what stated. So the minister did state all the proposed luxury tax will not affect basic food items. Okay. But in August 2017, when she talked about on a video chat on tax study, she listed the items that the government were looking at that the was imposed tax on. One was first class tickets on airline travels, luxury coaches, luxury goods, champagne, brandy, whiskey, wine, jewelry, and what? High-end jewelry. So those are the items that they mentioned. Okay. So the application rates that were stated during Natas regime. So they suggested that for those luxury items, that 10% importation surcharge for private jets, 39% import surcharge on luxury yachts, 5% import surcharge on luxury cars, undisclosed surcharge on business. For the business of first class airplane tickets, it did not disclose the amount that will be charged on it. Then for luxury surcharge on champagne, wines, and spirits, the percentage was, it was 3%. The rate was 3%. Then for FCT Abuja mansion tax on residential property valued at 3 million and above. So in FCT, which is Abuja, okay, any residential property that is valued at 300 million and above will pay what? 1% to government. So let's look at the benefits. These luxury goods, what are their benefits? Okay. Benefits of taxation of what? Luxury goods. I feel this will, especially in our current day, in 2020, with the coronavirus pandemic, we can see how it has affected businesses, not only in Nigeria, but also. So this form of tax could, especially now that oil, the revenue generated from oil and gas is low compared to before. So government can also look into this, okay, as a way to generate more income for government, okay? So let's look at the benefit of taxation of luxury goods. The benefits are one, to increase government revenue, okay? If we have in Nigeria, of Forbes, top 30 millionaires in Africa, and so on and so forth. The rich per se, okay? So if, for instance, we have over 100 billionaires, more than 100 multi-millionaires, and the highest number of world private jets owners in the country, okay? If tax is what is charged on these luxury items, this will also what raise government revenue, coupled with wealthy individuals that purchase expensive items from other countries. The annual revenue generated by government rewards will increase. Then to also broaden the tax base, okay? For the non-oil sector, tax base is expected to be broadened with the introduction of luxury reward tax. The revenue generated from the oil sector has declined since 2013. In fact, for this year, 2020, we can see even the payment, the date for payment of taxes has been. The date of payment, many companies have not been in operation for about 2 months now and counting. So the revenue from that aspect has already declined. Okay. So however, if governments look into that, the luxury tax will be one area for them to broaden their taxes. Then it's also to redistribute wealth from the poor to the rich. Like I said earlier on, I will not have the rich paying tax because especially when they also purchase expensive items. The tax generated from this source is expected to be used to provide social amenities to the citizens of the country, which will benefit the poor at the most. Okay. Then we also say it mitigates the consumption of non-essential goods and services. So before people will buy these expensive items, they will not also consider the amounts that will be involved in transporting the items. They also consider the tax rates that will be charged on these items. So all of that, it will help to mitigate the consumption of non-essential goods and services. The full implication of this tax may likely cause the penalty for the consumption of the extremely non-essential items in the world in the long run. The habit of the consumer of the item as well as the elasticity demand for the products may also determine the quantity to be worth purchased. So I think this is where we'll stop here for today, okay, and continue in our next class. Okay, now next class will begin with this Tertiary Education Act in our next class, okay? So we can just go through the material before our next class. Go through the material in our next class, make it easier for us and make us understand better. So now that questions, kindly send your questions to the chat room. I will go through it together. Once again, I apologize for the network problem and for starting late. Okay, so let's look at the question. Sorry for starting late, like I said before. Okay. Okay, we have a question here. Say, under payment schedule, the tax rate applied means what? Okay. For the tax payment schedule, for the tax payment schedule, we listed the various supporting documents that is needed in addition with the check that has been raised for payment of withholding tax. Okay. When we say tax rate applied, it means what tax rate did you use for the individual or for the company? Please, let's go back to the table we have there. You can see, when we say tax rate, what tax rate was used? If it's a company, what rate did you use? Was it 10% after you may have highlighted the transaction? What rate is it, 10%? Is it 5%? So the rate used, the percentage used, the rate that was charged on that amount has to be what stated. We have another question. I missed the explanation on the second advantage. Okay. Let me quickly go back to that. Advantage of, I guess you're talking about advantage of building sites. For advantage of withholding tax, it helps in expanding the tax net by roping in persons who were previously unknown to the tax authority. Give examples of, there are some companies that are registered with CAC, but they have not gone ahead to register with FRS. Now, next class, we'll look at that. Registration, remittance, the penalties. If you don't register with the relevant tax authority, what is not involved. Okay, if such individual or his company is previously unknown to the tax authority, they have not registered with the tax authority, this withholding tax can also help exposing such individuals or companies, because anybody that carries out businesses with them based on contracts and all, like we have listed above, those transactions and payments that are what that the withholding tax are to be charged on. Okay, by the time you present all the information in your payment schedules, all those information, the name, and you submit to, let's say, the relevant authorities, FRS, you submit to FRS, then they are trying to also send a notification to the taxpayer. This way, I told you these days, they do that in their emails. They realize that they don't even have the information of that taxpayer. The taxpayer have not registered FRS. In that case, you've already exposed that individual to the relevant tax authority. So they will not go ahead to find out why such individual's details is not in their with them. If probably the individual have not registered, or the individual just registered, but the necessary documentation have not been done, and so on and so forth. So it expands the tax needs by roping in persons who are previously unknown to the world tax authority. That's what I mean by that explanation. Then another question is, withholding tax payable on transactions settled by tax. When you say transactions settled by tax, what do you mean? Okay. You is withholding tax payable on transactions settled by cash? Yes, it's also payable on transactions settled by cash. Okay, whether they pay cash or they pay via transfer or by check, whichever means of payment, as long as so it involves those transactions that we listed above, rent and so on and so forth. What you do, before you pay the person the gross, the net amount, you deduct withholding tax and pay the individual. Are companies operating in free trade? Okay, can I see that? Could you quickly run through the second part of the question on Adebola again? Okay. All right, let me go through the second part of the question. For Adebola Limited, the second part, I guess you mean the net withholding tax payable or receivable by Adebola Nigeria Limited. No, Adebola Nigeria Limited is expected to remit what withholding tax, because Adebola Limited has paid what dividends. Remember, dividends is part of the transaction that we listed there that you had to charge withholding tax for. Okay. So since they've paid what dividends to their shareholders, they had to pay withholding tax. And they've also received dividend from a company that they what from another company. And that amount has also what so far. So what you do, Adebola Nigeria Limited pays withholding tax to the government. What Adebola will try to do is to find out what amount of withholding tax was paid on my behalf by the company. That amount of withholding tax, since the relevant tax authority have charged me tax already, that money is now like is now a credit to me, right? I can use it towards to reduce the withholding tax that I'm expected to pay based on the what the dividends to my shareholders. So I'm to pay a withholding tax of 600,000. Wow, do I know the other company that I received dividend for have paid a withholding tax of what 80,000 on my behalf already. So I will net off that amount from the withholding tax on the dividends what paid. Whatever I have will be the net amount to be what paid by my company for each of the years respectively. So that's all the question we have for now. Okay. So please, we can go through the documents again. There's another topic there, tertiary. I will send that to the platform now so you can all have it. Okay. Kindly read ahead of the class. Thank you very much for today. Okay, if you have any questions, always available. Have a good night. Rest till our next class next week. Bye for now. Hello, Prof, my host.
Hello.
Hello, Prof. I can hear you, sir.
Sir Omar. Hello, Prof.
Hello, Prof. I can hear you.
Yeah, I'm sure you can. I think we can end the class.
Okay, you're done with the class now.
Yes, okay,
thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you all for joining. We see you next class.